Do y'all want to know what I've learned in these dating streets? This may surprise you. That yes, you may have to compete for the man you want. Y'all who have known me may be surprised that I'm saying this. I saw a Crimson Cure, shout out to you sis, video and it resonated with me. I have competed for a lot of other things in my life. My job, education, sports. Why wouldn't I compete for the best quality male that I could possibly get in my life with and have children with? That decision's way more important than the other things. Honestly, have never been taught that, never. I can see it. So how do I do it now? Or how do I recommend you doing it? By initiating calls and texts. You ain't gotta blow the man's phone up, but you can initiate once or twice. Maybe me introducing myself or strike up a conversation with someone I think is interesting. Maybe even initiating making plans. Don't audition, but let them know you're interested. Let them experience the beauty of your presence.
Shout out to her because, you know, I think I've reacted to her content before and I love how she kind of speaks to women, but yet she's speaking to men at the same time. You know, what we got to understand is, you know, in this generation that we live in with Instagram and, you know, dating apps and all these different type of things, man, a lot of women feel like they don't have to compete for a man. And what I mean by that is a lot of women just feel like their looks and how they look and what's fat back there and these up here, they feel like that's all they got to bring to the table. And a lot of men fall for that. And a lot of men feel like, man, I gotta go chase that. I gotta go get that. But a lot of men are thinking that way. That's what perpetuates women feeling like they don't have to compete. That's why, what do they say? 3% of the men get 97% of the women. And that's true to a certain extent. You know, what you gotta understand is women won't compete for the average dude no more. You know what I'm saying? This ain't the 60s where, you know, when women barely had bank accounts, barely could work jobs, and they were relying on that average man. But the point of this video is that the focus as a man should be to level up. When you level up as a man, you demand a woman to be able to compete, you know what I'm saying, to be in your life. But forget all of that, you know what I'm saying? A woman should be an asset in your life regardless. And if you just accept a woman looking good and that's all that she has to bring to the table, she's not going to work for you. So you as a man, your job is to qualify the women that are around you. But so much of us men were so attracted to how they look, was fat back there, you know what I'm saying? They got these big up here, we chasing. And when you coming from that mindset, you know what I'm saying? A woman ain't gonna qualify for you. You gonna have to qualify for her. And you know, I know I'm all over the place with this video, but this is why, like, as a man, you only focus on women who invest into you. All that other stuff is for the birds, man. Women that make it difficult, they making you chase them like they're the prize, because what's gonna end up happening is in those type of situations, she's gonna end up being the man and you're gonna be the woman and you're gonna hate your life and you're gonna resent her. You know what I'm saying? That's why you only deal with women who invest into you as a man. That's it. Because at the end of the day, every king needs his queen. You know what I'm saying? As a man, you're the foundation, man. And you know, what I hate about this society is, you know what I'm saying? This is some real spill. What I hate about this society is, like, man, like, it's teaching women that to rely on their looks and that they don't have to bring nothing else to the table. But also what perpetuates that is us men, we chase women and we don't chase our purpose. You know what I'm saying? We're chasing women who don't want us, who already shown us that they're not attracted to us, and we continue to do that. And that's most men that do that. Every 9 out of 10 men are chasing women that don't want us. And what that causes is in a woman's brain, because you gotta think. I can't even blame women for thinking the way they do, because you gotta think, if you have all these men chasing you, are you gonna feel like you need to bring anything to the table? Tell me, if you had 20 women chasing you in your inbox, had 100 men, women chasing you in your DMs, you wouldn't feel the need to do anything. And that's what's going on. So we gotta bring back men focusing on their craft, men focusing on their purpose. Because when you see, with me, I have a certain expectation. I have self-respect. I have standards for myself. So for the women that are around me, you gotta bring something to the table. Whether that's buying, you know what I'm saying, bringing the liquor when you come over, or remember paying for a date every now and then. You gotta bring something to the table. It just can't be your looks. But what's crazy is looks satisfy most men, and that's all they you know what I'm saying, require, because they're moving out of scarcity. See, when you are moving from a place of scarcity, you don't know what it's like to feel abundant. You know what I'm saying? Back in my early 20s, man, like, I was moving straight out of scarcity because I didn't know what it was like to have what I wanted. I didn't know what it was like to have a woman who was attracted to me. So I was moving straight out of scarcity. So I wasn't in the mode of saying, oh man, she gotta bring something to the table, because I just wanted anything. I just wanted to catch one. And also too, what I really wanna relay over to you guys is, man, when a woman really wants you, she will compete for you. And the thing is, women try to make that seem like, oh, I'm not competing for no man. I get my own. You know, women are trying to make it seem like that. But what I mean by that is their version of competition means they may buy you different things. They may show you appreciation in different ways. They may pay for things. That's women showing that they're willing to compete for your time and your attention. Those are the type of women that you want around, the ones that understand the value of having a man in their life. You don't want a woman who feels like, oh, you gotta be my husband for me to cook for you and all these different type of things. Now, I understand there's certain things that you shouldn't be doing in a relationship that you would do in a marriage. Some things you have to keep mysterious. I do understand that. But also too, at the same time, a woman is not investing nothing but just showing up, and she feels like that's enough because it's just her presence. You don't want a woman like that around, because you're gonna have to end up bowing down to that woman, or your life is gonna be difficult. And also too, you gotta think about it. There's a reason why most of these women that you see on Instagram, all these models, a lot of these dancers, there's a reason why they're not married. You know what I'm saying? There's a reason for that, because they're not willing to invest more than their looks into a situation. Or maybe they, and it can be a variety of things. Obviously, I'm speaking in a generic sense, but the overall point is that, man, as a man, focus on yourself. Only deal with women who like you. And I know it's hard. It's definitely hard when you're attracted to a woman and you like her and you're not getting that reciprocated. I understand that, but you gotta be able to move on, because, you know, being with a woman that doesn't really want you like that's not a good thing. That's super toxic. That's hella toxic. And, you know, you can't win out that situation. You only want to deal with women who make it easy for you, invest into you. Women that, and this is huge, women that support your dreams and your ambitions and your aspirations, because a woman who don't see your vision is not the woman for you. So at the end of the day, focusing on you is the best thing that you can do, but also having standards for yourself and the women that you bring around you. Because when you have standards for yourself and the women that bring around you, that's where the respect comes into play, because women cannot love men that they don't respect. And if you're chasing her all the time, she can't respect you. You trying to get her to submit. Ooh, you submit to me? A woman is not gonna submit to a dude that she doesn't respect. And if you don't respect yourself, she will never respect you. All right, guys, that's my video for today, man. I appreciate all the new subscribers to the channel, guys. Guys, make sure you continue to like, comment, and subscribe to the channel. And I'm gone.